Welcome, everyone. I'm Andrew Kornblatt, and I'm here live from the Mission Blue headquarters in San Francisco. The Secretary of State John Kerry and the State Department has put together a worldwide conference of stakeholders, policymakers, and experts from the ocean community. To offer the message of hope for our ocean, the conference is ending with a screening of the Mission Blue film at the National Geographic headquarters. In this hangout, we will be reviewing the conference and speaking about the important steps that need to be taken.
Well, it's really fascinating, and I met Secretary Kerry this morning. We met his dog, too, Ben. It was really nice to hear him talk about the oceans and how important it is to, like, protect the oceans and how much, like, even the younger kids can do it by, like, picking up trash, reducing, reusing, and recycling.
And we've spent the last several years working with many partners to mesh all of the underwater terrain data together and create a virtual map, which can be used by anyone, either the government or nonprofits, to communicate what's going on in the ocean, serving a bit of a convening role to gather all that information together and make it more searchable and discoverable. But there are a number of various ocean stories, photos, videos about the ocean to kind of bring the ocean to life. And if you click on the turtle, it takes you to underwater street view. And we published about 25 locations in partnership with the Catlin Sea View Survey from areas all around the world. And I think this tool can be a way to help bring people to these places. And if people can sort of explore it virtually and follow along, I think it can be a powerful tool for education. And I should say that you're partnering with National Geographic on their education platform. And we're hopeful that these tools can bring all of this beautiful, inspiring imagery of these protected areas to a larger audience.
An amazing way to be able to talk about our life support system. The reason why I'm spending 31 days underwater is mainly to make this a communal platform so that we can talk more in depth about the importance of oceans. Obviously, exploration is a great lens by which we can engage and energize the general public who may never get a chance to do this, much less even get to the ocean.
Being the new president and CEO of the New England Aquarium, it was very exciting for me to hear the announcement yesterday from President Tong from Kiribati. And he just announced that all commercial fishing is going to be banned from that really huge marine protected area. And that's incredibly good news for tuna and other large fish in that area.
This area right here is where we're talking about. It's around the size of, I want to say California.
Yes, I believe that's a very accurate description. It is at least the size of California.
As you know, I spent 17 days at 60 feet with Fabian down on the ocean bottom. We had an incredibly great and successful time. We worked tirelessly on several nights to create different images. The shot that's up right now is of Fabian swimming down from the top of the habitat towards the ocean floor. This is Jeke. He is an enormous Goliath grouper. He's one of our very, very favorite residents there at Aquarius. But we also have another grouper that would come to the window every night. Her name was Sylvia, aptly named after Sylvia Earle. In fact, last night she went after a barracuda and we were able to film that. It was an incredible sight for all of us. It was really wild down there. It was like Jurassic Park underwater. It's kind of the iconic image for Aquarius. It showed Fabian looking out. I've been so fortunate to have spent time in many different places around the world and unfortunately see some of these changes firsthand. But at the same time, I think it's important not to give up hope and not to dwell on the negativity surrounding some of those issues.
For those of you who are watching, 71% of the planet is covered by ocean. And 64% of that ocean belongs to each and every one of you who are watching this. It's your global commons. And so what the Terramar Project does is it gives you an opportunity to connect to that 64% of the ocean and to have a voice and a say for the first time in really what happens to it. Come to the terramarproject.org website, you sign the pledge. You get a digital passport that makes you a dual citizen of land and sea.
I have Sylvia here. Nice to see you.
it's a human experience. Mm-hmm. And there was a time when I think it was considered a bit unusual for a woman to go on a ship, go to sea, or to be a diver, or live underwater, but it's changed very quickly. Well, it's really, I suppose, me as a witness of what's happened to the ocean, what is happening, both in terms of the good news about how we can now better explore the ocean, take care of the ocean, but also about what's happened to the ocean just in my lifetime and certainly in yours. Think about taking care of the ocean, taking care of the natural world that takes care of us. The film is going to be aired for the first time publicly, I mean globally, on Netflix on the 15th of August. But we have a little preview going on right here at the National Geographic right now. So I have to be off because I'm going to be there to launch it. And I look forward to having you come.
Between the consortium of people who really care about the ocean, Dr. Sylvia Earle, who came down here about a week ago, and many others who have participated in Mission 31 on various levels, Richard Branson this morning on a Google Hangout, and so on and so forth, I hope that we can leverage those efforts, that focus, that public awareness, so that we can get government to realize that this, our natural resource bank account, is something that we need to highlight in every conversation, whether it's at home or on the government level.